everyone. I hope you've been having a great time so far during the fast. My name is Gabriel. Welcome to our devotional today. So today I want to just read the Bible with you, and we're going to be reading out of the book of Nehemiah. And I want to talk about this topic, how goals really determine our success. Success begins with having a vision and then setting goals to accomplish that vision. Nehemiah chapter 1, verse 3 through 4, it says, "They said to me, 'Things are not going well for those who return to the province of Judah. They are in great trouble and disgrace. The wall of Jerusalem has been torn down, and the gates have been destroyed by fire.' When I heard this, I sat down and wept. In fact, for days I mourned, fasted, and prayed to the God of heaven." You know, in this moment, God is birthing a vision inside of Nehemiah. And it's coming from a place of receiving this bad news that his people are in a very bad place, that they're being destroyed, that they're being raped and pillaged, and they're being attacked. And so he goes into a time of prayer. He goes into a time of fasting for his people. But look what comes out of that time. God gives him something. And if you go down to verse 11 with me, it says, "Oh Lord, please hear my prayer. Listen to the prayers of those of us who delight in honoring you. Please grant me success today by making the king favorable to me. Put it into his heart to be kind to me." And in those days, it says that he was the king's cup bearer. Nehemiah 2, chapter 2, verse 4 through 5. This is the time where Nehemiah actually has a conversation with the king, and he starts to share the vision that he really has. The king asked, "Well, how can I help you?" "With a prayer to the God of heaven, I replied, 'If it pleases the king, and if you are pleased with me, your servant, send me to Judah to rebuild the city where my ancestors are buried.'" So what is Nehemiah's vision? Nehemiah's vision is to rebuild the city where his ancestors are buried. That's his vision. And he's going to begin to, when we go to verse 6 and 8, we're going to see he starts listing things in his conversation with the king. And it's very detailed. And these are the goals. Remember, we said we have a vision, but then we need to set some goals to accomplish the vision. And you know, without goals, there's no vision. You know, you see this airplane that I have right here. It was a vision that somebody had to create a faster way, right, to travel. But it couldn't be just a vision. It had to be a vision with goals attached to it. Why? So that the vision could actually come to pass. And that vision has come to pass to where we have airplanes, we have jets, we have helicopters. And in the same way, Nehemiah, in chapter 2, verse 6 through 8, he begins to lay out some of the goals that are attached to his vision. It says in, we're going to start with verse 6, Nehemiah 2, verse 6. "The king, with the queen sitting beside him, asked, 'How long will you be gone? When will you return?' After I told him how long I would be gone, the king agreed to my request. I also said to the king, 'If it pleases the king, let me have letters addressed to the governors of the province of west of the Euphrates River, instructing them to let me travel safely through their territories on my way to Judah. And please give me a letter addressed to Asaph, the manager of the king's forest, instructing him to give me timber. I will need it to make beams for the gates of the temple's fortress, for the city walls, and for a house for myself.' And the king granted these requests because the gracious hand of God was on me." So you see him laying out these things. He's laying out specific goals that he has, specific needs that he has in order to accomplish what? His vision to rebuild his people's city. Nehemiah 2, verse 11 through 12, it says, "So I arrived in Jerusalem. 3 days later, I slipped out during the night, taking only a few others with me. I had not told anybody about the plans God had put in my heart for Jerusalem. We took no pack animals with us except the donkey that I was riding." And Nehemiah verse 17 through 20, it says, chapter 2, same chapter. But now I said to them, you know very well what trouble we are in. Jerusalem lies in ruins, and its gates have been destroyed by fire. Let us rebuild the wall of Jerusalem and end this disgrace. Then I told them about how the gracious hand of God had been on me, and about my conversation with the king. They replied at once, yes, let's rebuild the wall. So they began the good work. But when Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem, the Arab, heard of our plan, they scoffed. What are you doing? Are you rebelling against the king? They asked. I replied, the God of heaven will help us succeed. We, his servants, will start rebuilding this wall. But you have no share, legal right, or historic claim in Jerusalem. You see, so Nehemiah, and we're going to see how this story ends, but Nehemiah is going after this vision, right? And you're seeing he's talking to his king. He's getting the permission there. He's even has a timeline to his vision being accomplished. He has some people coming against him, right? But when you have goals set in place to achieve your vision, no matter who comes against you, these goals help you to stay focused in the time of pursuing the vision that God has put on your heart. I remember when we were given an assignment to launch 1,000 home Bible studies that we were going to do online, and it was an urgent assignment. And I remember at first that I got the vision. But then as I looked at the vision, all I could see was all these different ways to accomplish the vision. And so I started creating goals, steps to get to our vision, to a place where now we not only hit the 1,000 goal, but we have over 1,200 home Bible studies that we were able to accomplish and launch out. But without having goals, it would have just been a nice dream. It would have just been a vision. Nehemiah chapter 6, verse 15 through 16. It says, so on October 2nd, the wall was finished. Just 52 days after we had begun, when our enemies and the surrounding nations heard about it, they were frightened and humiliated. They realized this work had been done with the help of God. So Nehemiah, he succeeded in his vision. He succeeded because he had goals to accomplish the vision. So there's some benefits of goal setting that I want to just touch on really, really quick. Goals keep you from wasting time and energy. Goals produce focus and helps us to avoid distractions. Goals simplify your decision-making process. Goals deliver you from living in the past. And goals produce persistence and determination. So my question for you is, what is your vision? What's your vision for your family? What's your vision for your ministry? What's your vision for your finances? What are your goals to accomplish this vision that you have, or these visions that you have? Let's write out these things today. Let's take some time. It could be 5 minutes, it could be during your lunch break, it could be before you go to bed, or earlier in the morning when you're drinking your coffee. But let's find a time that we could write down some steps to this vision, some goals to these visions. And I believe that as you write down these goals, as you write down these steps, you're gonna see yourself accomplishing vision after vision after vision. Thank you guys so much. Let's have a great day today. And let's write these goals out. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.